Another crazy story out of Connecticut. Oh, my goodness. I don't know why the community is divided on this. It says the community is divided after a white elementary school teacher was put on administrative leave after casting two black students as slaves in a play.
Okay.
So Carmen,
what the hell is that?
Yeah, Carmen Parker said her 10-year-old daughter came home last week and said that she'd be playing an enslaved African number two in A Triangle of Trade, which is a play at Westwoods Elementary School in Hamden, Connecticut. This is part of a curriculum. Like, this is something that the teacher could go on the shelf and say, oh, let me pull this play, A Triangle of Trade. Scholastic produced this Triangle of Trade. Hmm. She and her classmate, a young black boy, had been he was cast as enslaved African number one. They had to read aloud. It centered on the transatlantic slave trade, and it was published by Scholastic in 2003 as an anthology of short instructional plays about colonial America. And so it seeks to provide some economic insights about why European rulers and their colonists agreed to such a morally reprehensible venture as slavery, and why African rulers might have joined in, check this out, despite the harm to their people. That's Scholastic, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So Parker said, the mother said, we don't even play cowboys and Indians anymore. How are we playing slaves and masters? Like, what in the hell is going on here?
This happens at least five times a year.
Yes.
All over the country. And I've always said this because my sister is in education. She's been a teacher for 18 years. So we always joke about the things you can and can't do. And I'm always saying in these scenarios, the only way they can work is if you did that play and cast the white kids
as enslaved people. Yes.
That's the only way it can work. Because you'll feel that.
Right.
The audience
Jane Elliott's brown-eyed, blue-eyed.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's the only way that can work.
Yeah.
If you want to play around, since you want to play around.
Right. No, you can't. You cannot cast the black kids.
Yeah, try it the other
way. Right.
And see what happens.
Which says a lot.
Authenticity.
So in this Hamden Public School District, 90% of the teachers are white. Mm. 60% of the students are black.
Of course.
So that's a whole other color. Yeah. That says a lot, right? And so the teacher's on administrative leave. Why is she fired? Well, you know, to Ms. Parker's
point. She apologized, probably.
Probably, but Ms. Parker is an assistant professor of psychiatry at Yale. So she wasn't the one to have her daughter come home and say, Mommy, I'm playing an enslaved African number two. She said the teachers are not the scapegoat for a system that is clearly broken and has been suppressing minority voices and the voices of those with disabilities. She threw that in there. I would like to support the teacher to learn how to make a better community for our minority students. But, you know, this is deeper than that.
Yeah.
And how are you in a classroom teaching global majority kids?
Right.
And you don't understand why it's problematic to cast a fifth grader, a 10-year-old, as an enslaved person. Like, that shouldn't even, like, that should have been like a knee-jerk, no, this is wrong.
Yeah, right. What message am I sending?
And is that the only concept of our history? Like, that
Yes,
we
apparently.
Always, you know, like, what are some other things that we can teach
the Candaces,
and reenact?
Mansa Musa, Shaka Zulu.
The homie warriors.
Since we're talking about Black Panther, Dora Milaje were actual real warriors.
Right.
Let's celebrate them. And you could play the one that, what's her name? Lupita? No, she wasn't a Dora Milaje. Who's it? Denaya. Guerrera.
Yeah.
Yes. Play that one. I don't know.
We got to do better.
Do you think?
We.
But here's the thing. I was going to say, we're good.
Yeah.
First of all, I couldn't send my child to a school where 90% of the staff, the teachers were white.
And
I just wouldn't feel
60%
comfortable.
60% of the students
were
a
black.
A lot of times you don't have no choice, though.
Yes, you do have a choice. You show up to your Board of Ed meeting and say, I need to have teachers that reflect the community that you're teaching.
There's
that
power.
That sounds good, though. That sounds good. How often does that happen in school districts?
Connecticut?
Around America.
Well, it should. You have a kid. That's your responsibility.
I mean, it's a lot of shoulds. Teachers should be paid more.
Yeah, I agree with
How
that, too.
How about that one?
I agree.
So that's,
I agree.
Yeah.
So let's work on that. Lamont, that's your job.
I put that on my platform.
Connecticut, do better.
Yeah. Be better. 866-801-8255. We got a lot of calls. Let's go to Cliff in Connecticut. Hey, Cliff.
Hey, Karen. How's it going? Love you to death.
To life. I want to be loved to life.
Oh, yeah, love you to life.
I need all of that.
And back.
Thank you.
Love you just period. Mm. I want my sleep mattress being right next to you the whole night. Anyway.
Mm. What's your number?
You're beautiful.
What would your sleep number be?
Yeah, what's your sleep number?
Whatever Same as yours.
Ooh, okay. Nice.
All right. Well, okay. 75. We both have a firm mattress.
150.
It doesn't go up that high.
Here's my point. I'm from Connecticut.
75
But we do have a serious problem. And so even in Waterbury, Connecticut, the same thing. We're dealing with 90% of our students being black, and then like 80-95% of the teachers are all white. But then when I go and I advocate and say to the NAACP that this is an issue we should be concerned with, nothing. We don't want to cause any problems because these teachers, and this is what happens, are appointed and hired by or under the Democratic leadership. And that's a problem. So locally, on a statewide, the NAACP and the preachers should address these issues. And when they don't, you just have one person that's pretty much speaking on this issue with no impact and no power. And that's what happens in Connecticut.
So who's in charge in Connecticut?
I know. And he just hit a major thing, like understanding that racism exists in every political party, you know, and so it's these.
And so what he's also saying is that the support, I'm putting up air quotes, the check that local NAACP must be getting from those politicians, they give you the check to shut the F up.
Right.
You get the check so that you can keep the other darkies at bay. So you take the money, and because you took the money, you're going to go out, and this is the classic.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
You got to agitate.
Classic. Yeah. It's classic.
Yeah,
it is. What price is your soul, people? Come on, y'all.
I mean, because these are our babies.
I would take the money and still hold them accountable.
Exactly.
Take it back. I dare you.
Especially when you look at the numbers, when you're talking about, I think he said 90%.
Yeah, he said 90% probably in his area. But Hamden is 60%, 90% of the
teachers. But, I mean, there are a lot of urban areas where that is what it is.
You're correct. 866-801-8255.
It's probably 100% in some places.
Yeah.